In this video, I'm gonna teach you how to connect PlayStation 4 controller to BeamNG drive. It's a very easy process, so make sure to follow along. In this video, I'm gonna teach you how you can easily set up any controller, including a PlayStation 4 controller, to play BeamNG drive. So as you might be aware, when you are using a keyboard and mouse to play games like BeamNG Drive, the experience is quite poor, so you can improve it by using a controller or a steering wheel. For this video, you don't need any external tools, so a very popular one that most people use is Ps4 Windows. However, for this method, you don't even need it. All that you have to do is run the game through Steam. Don't worry, even if you own BeamNG Drive outside of Steam, you can still follow this method. So first, open the Steam launcher. Now, if you don't have the game on Steam, use the method that I'm going to show now. If you do, then you can skip ahead. So what you have to do is click the option to add a game and then add a non-Steam game. This will show you all of the programs available on your PC, and you simply have to look for BeamNG Drive here. When you find it, pretend, for example, this was it, you would be able to take the option and then add the game. Sadly, I don't have BeamNG Drive installed on this computer. But after you add BeamNG Drive to your library, you just right-click it and go to the properties. I'm going to be demonstrating this with Dirt 3, but just follow the exact same steps, and it is going to work with BeamNG Drive instead. So when you right-click the game, go over to Properties, you have to select Controller, and in here, make sure that Steam Input is enabled. Steam Input is a feature that automatically detects and sets up any controllers that you connect, including a PlayStation 4 controller. So even though the DualShock 4 is notoriously difficult to be used with Windows for gaming, you can set it up easily with Steam Input. So enable the option here, and now just go over to the controller configurator. If your controller disconnects, then a screen like this will appear, so I'm just going to reconnect my controller. But as long as you make sure that it is properly connected, either through a cable or wirelessly, whatever you prefer, you will be able to get this done. So once again, if you go over to the controller configurator, you will be able to change everything in here. So I am using an Xbox controller for this demonstration, but if you have a DualShock, this one is going to be selected, and all that you have to do is browse through the templates. I recommend going over to Community Layouts and looking for a particular one for your PlayStation 4 controller, so the DualShock 4. Alternatively, you can make your own by changing every single button and customizing the layout to your own preferences. It is simple to do, and you can change everything about it. As long as you run the game through Steam with Steam Input enabled, it is going to natively set up your DualShock 4. I hope I was able to help you on how to connect PlayStation 4 controller to BeamNG. If this video helped you, please be sure to leave a like and subscribe for more very easy tips. Thank you for watching!